What's going on, people of the internet?
I'm FredEFlame, aka FredEFuego, Flame and Hot Entertainment. Today I'm bringing you a quick couple of games that I played, and I'll give you a little input on them. I never got to play Socom for online. So yesterday the network went on, I played online, but I didn't play with any of my friends. So today I woke up, tried to get on with my friends, and the game makes it virtually impossible to play with your friends. It's just no party, you know what I'm saying? You know, no party system. No being able to go to the same type of matches, because it matches you up with people already and the game's almost full. So then when your friends try to get in, there ain't no way to get in. It's horrendous. It's horrible. It's pathetic. It really is. This is what I get for Socom 4. That's what I'd say. It's garbage. Don't pick it up. If you want to play by yourself, if you usually play a one-man army type guy, or, you know, you got one or two friends to play or whatever, yeah, you know what I'm saying? It's okay. It's okay game. But I like to play with my friends, and it's just, online gaming is a social, thing. And I have many friends that I play with. And if it can't be a social thing for me, then it's no good for me. And then the offline part, the story mode, is mediocre at best, my personal opinion. I think Socom Confrontation was more of a Socom game than Socom 4. A lot of people agree with me on that. Those ain't my exact words, but those were the words best said to fit how I felt about the game. That wasn't my quote. That was a quote. Boo Boy Kendo told me that, and I felt the same exact way. Anyways, Socom 4. Brink. I seen Brink being played online by a couple people, and I asked them if it was glitchy, is it buggy, is it laggy. And they said no problems, just, you know, it kind of feels sluggish when it's loading up and syncing all the players together before the, but they said after the ticker on the clock to start the match, it works like any other, you know what I'm saying, any other game that's pretty stable. So what I'm going to do is I'm probably going to pick up Brink tomorrow on the PS3, play it. I know on the PC it's fucking awesome. It's phenomenal. You know, there's little bugs here and there with the audio bugs. The frame rate wasn't really constant, but I played it. Like I said, I get anywhere from 20 to 65 frames a second, so I was good. I'm normally used to playing at 30 frames a second, which most games play at 30 frames a second. What else? I'm going to try to build a PC gaming rig. I don't have much money allocated for that. I try to do it with my my Mac Pro through boot camp, and if I fail terribly, so I got these parts that I'm actually gonna put into.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen of the internet? I am FredEFlame, aka FredEFuego, Flame and Hot Entertainment. Today I am bringing you a quick purchase update. All right, we have right here, this is a dongle for your iDevice that turns your iDevice into a universal remote control and can learn every remote control's function via the RF blaster, and you put it next to each other and it learns the controller, and you could configure it all you want and all that good stuff, and it's very it's customizable, fully customizable. Now this right here is just a box or whatever, and it is system builder pack, OEM system builder pack intended for system builders only. This is Windows 7, right, where is it? Windows 7, Service Pack 1, 64-bit English 1 pack. All right. Now that let this. All right. Then we have the ATI Radeon HD 5770, and this is the FX version of it. And I'll do next time you see when it edits out. I'll actually, sorry for the shitty camera, doing, but this is called the Razer Nostromo expert gaming keypad for experts, and that's some of it right there. And let's see if we can't get there it goes. And this thing is freaking righteous. That's what it looks like. A couple keys in here. Then it has like a little thumb pad for directions. Well, that's it. I'll take everything out the box. I don't do unboxings. That's my time to get giddy with something and get childish. Next time, when the video pops back up, you'll see everything unboxed and it'll be edited in and all that good stuff and all that magic that happens post-production. All right, this is the second part. Just go through a quick overview. Radeon HD 5770. And the box comes out. The box is really nice. The packaging is okay. Took off the plastic, so it's nice and glossy. Has two DVI ports, one HDMI port. And the other one, I will tell you right now what the other port is, because I don't know the name of it. Let's see what it says on the box. Comes with DVI, VGA, 6-pin, serial key, drivers. Dual mode ATI crossfire technology supported, highly scalable performance. Display port. HDMI to digital DVI. It's a display port. OpenGL. Okay. 5-star support. You got the Windows 7 OEM pack. Professional 64-bit. Going in the Mac Pro 1.1. Everything, the boxes right here, the Nostromo box. There you go, focus. That's the back of the card. You see the two. Alright. Then the power, 8-pin power connector, which is right here. Right in here. It's a 6-pin power connector. 6-pin, not 8-pin. Alright, the L5 adapter for the phone. And then let's see this beast, which I love this thing already, and I haven't even used it. It's just because of the way it feels. Your hand fits on it good. Got the roller ball. It clicks in. It has 15 keys. They're all backlit. It has a 8-directional keypad that it doesn't click in, but it has a It has a button here. And it feels very matte finish, silky smooth. It does have a button in the back that I don't know what's for right now. If you can see right there. But I will figure that out soon. Then this is my Mac Pro. I got all 4 hard drive bays full. I have 9 gigs of RAM. I only have 2 slots left. I'm probably going to put another 4 gigs in there. I have an NVIDIA card that came with it that's right above, right below those hard drives. I'm probably going to take that out today and give these cards more space. I have another ATI 5770 Radeon HD graphics card in there. I'm going to be cross-firing those with this nice 5-inch crossfire bridge. And it's right there. and you will see me on Steam. My name is FredEFuego, just like my my YouTube, my PSN ID, and all that good stuff. If it doesn't work with the dashes, just put FredEFuego without the dashes, and it should work. And that's it. I am Freddy Flame, aka FredEFuego, Flamin' Hot Entertainment. I will be bringing you updates, reviews on my products, telling you how they work, if they're worth the money, if I would recommend them to anybody. So if you want to see more of that, hit that subscribe button, hit the like button, favorite this video if you want to, share it with somebody, tell your friends about it, go crazy in the town, rape, pillage, and plunder the gaming community. Teabag your neighbor. Do all that good stuff. Teabag your neighbor. Just make sure your neighbor ain't Stewie Griffin. He might like it. Alright, I'm out of here. Peace, love, and hair grease. Haters keep on hating. And if you haven't been doing it, you need to get gaming. Alright, as you've seen the parts that I have that I just did and mixed into this video through post-production, you see what I got. So I want to be able to use these parts, and I want to be able to use these things and not have it as a loss or a waste or have to ship them back or anything. So, they're pretty cool pieces, you know what I'm saying? And like I said, that little Nostromo gaming keypad, that's a peak. That looks like I'm going to be able to pwn something with that. Very, very comfortable in my hand. I really like it. So tell me what y'all think. If y'all played Brink on the PS3... tell me what you think about it. Any problems with it? I'm asking the people that actually play it. I'm tired of listening to reviewers. I'm gonna make my own. I like making my own choices. I don't like being one of these sheep being led to the slaughter. So, anyways, I am Freddy Flame, aka Freddy Fuego, Flame of Hot Entertainment, Peace, Love, and Hair Grease. And yes, this is Mario riding Yoshi. And if you don't like it, if you're a fanboy and you don't like Mario, that just makes you a fanboy. Everybody loves Mario. Peace, love, and hair grease. Haters keep on hating. If you haven't been doing it, you need to get gaming.